Now we'll see about erythrocyte sedimentation rate. So what is ESR? ESR is common term used to erythrocyte sedimentation rate, one of the investigation performed routinely in our laboratory. It is the rate of downward descent of RBCs in a vertical column of blood. What is the principle? Principle is, if anticoagulated blood is allowed to stand vertically in a narrow tube, the red cells will settle progressively to the bottom, leaving the clear plasma above. The cells settle due to, because the density of RBC is greater than the plasma, then RBCs tend to aggregate to form ROLU formation. So ROLU differs from agglutination, that agglutinated cells are irreversibly bound together and cannot be separated, but in a ROLU formation RBCs can be separated. See, these are the disc shaped RBCs. You can see the shape of the erythrocytes, and a shake or a coin thula sarka dista, that is called as ROLU formation. So there are two methods mainly used for ESR analysis. First is the Westergren's method and Windrow's method. So let us see something about the Westergren method for estimation of ESR. So what are the equipments required? The specially designed glass tube is there. It's called as Westergren tube. This glass tube is 30 cm in length, 2.5 mm in diameter, and it is graduated from 0 to 200 mm. And there is a special stand to keep these tubes in a straight manner. 3.8% sodium citrate is used, 5 ml disposable syringe is used. And now coming to the procedure, we draw blood sample in a syringe and mix it with 3.8% sodium citrate at a ratio 4:1, that is 2 ml of blood plus 0.5 ml of sodium citrate is taken. Then suck the citrated blood to Westergren tube up to zero mark exactly and place your finger over its opening. Place the tube in a special stand that fix the upper lip of a lip with a clip. The height of clear plasma on the top of the tube is measured after 1 and 2 hours. See, this is a stand and the central one is the tube filled with the blood. This is a special Westergren tube for ESR. So what are the normal values of ESR in a health? Yeah, in males it is, for first hour 3 to 5 mm, for second hour 6 to 10 mm. In females, for first hour is 8 to 10 mm, after second hour is 16 to 20 mm. So what is the clinical significance of ESR? Kaan karacha ESR? Because the ESR is change in a great variety of conditions. Its alteration is non-specific and non-diagnostic, but this is an important marker as a prognostic test. So it detects the presence and severity of disease, even though it is not specific and not diagnostic. It gives an idea about the activity of the disease. Then repeated ESR estimation helps in prognosis and follow-up of the disease. So what are the factors determining the rate of sedimentation of RBCs? These are plasma proteins. First is the albumin. If plasma albumin level is increased, the ESR decreases. Then fibrinogen and globulins. If plasma fibrinogen or globulin levels is increased, the ESR increases. Then next component is red cell count. If RBC count is increased, the ESR decreases. And what are the factors affecting ESR? There are few physiological factors which affect the ESR. ESR is increased in old age, in females, in pregnancy, in menstruation. ESR is decreased in newborns, males, high attitude. Then coming to the pathological fractures. Pathological factors, these are ESR is increased in acute inflammation as tonsillitis, malignancy, chronic inflammation as tuberculosis, fevers, rheumatic fever, trauma to the tissues, and it is decreased in polycythemia. What is polycythemia? Is increased in the hemoglobin count more than the normal range of that patient. Hyperviscosity of the plasma. So these are the factors. Now coming to the Wintrob and Landsberg method. So what is the principle? The principle is well mixed whole blood is placed in a Wintrob tube and allowed to stand for 1 hour. The number of millimeters the RBCs fall during time constitutes the ESR. In the Wintrob and Landsberg method, normal values for women are 0 to 20 and 0 to 9 mm for men. What are the reagents and equipment? It requires Wintrob tube calibrated in millimeters, Wintrob pipette rack, disposable capillary pipette, applicator sticks. Specimen required is whole blood 1 ml using EDTA as the anticoagulant. Now coming to the procedure, mix the whole blood for at least 2 minutes on a rotator. Blood should be at room temperature for some time. Check the tube for clots using toe applicator sticks. With a capillary pipette, fill the Wintrob tube to the zero mark. Place the tube in an exactly vertical position in the rack, time for 60 minutes. And at the end of the 60 minutes, that is 1 hour, record the level of erythrocyte column. This result is the ESR in millimeter per hour. So, this is all about the erythrocyte sedimentation rate.